Grammar. Whether it's a joy or a terrifying burden, it's most certainly on the SAT, and I'm here to help you conquer it. Welcome back to SAT for Free. Hi everyone, and welcome to Lesson 7 of SAT for Free. My name is Dressler Parsons, one of Student-Tutor's most renowned writers and editors. And believe it or not, I actually like grammar. Today's lesson is all about grammar. That's right, that pesky part of the writing section in which they ask you to correct grammatical errors, rewrite poorly constructed sentences, and fix badly organized paragraphs. The SAT grammar questions are pretty difficult, but once you know what to look for, the answers become crystal clear. Here's what you need to know in order to do well. First, if you're not enrolled in our free 5-week SAT program yet, make sure to do so by clicking here. Also, if you haven't read the reading assignment on SAT grammar topics, make sure to do that before you watch the video by clicking here. So, the first grammar concept you need to know, parts of speech. You might have watched Schoolhouse Rock before, and you might think you know all about parts of speech. But how much do you really know? Well, first, what parts are there? Well, for starters, verbs, nouns, adjectives. This is a review, right? Let's say you're given a sentence on the SAT with two verbs underlined. What should you look for? Most likely, there's a problem with the verb tenses. Ask yourself, do these verb tenses match up? Are they both past tense? Are they both present tense? Because if one's past and one's present, then you've found the error. One more thing. In any given sentence, the verb must agree with the subject. So, what does that mean? For example, a singular noun, like the word he, must be accompanied by the singular verb is. Would you say, he are going to the store? Of course not. You should say, he is going to the store. That brings me to our next important topic, singular words versus plural words. This is a concept you learned ages ago, so you'd think it'd be pretty easy, right? Well, as it turns out, a lot of students really struggle with these types of questions. If you saw the sentence, "the government are bad," you might think it looks okay. After all, there are multiple people involved in the government, so it can be pretty tempting to accompany the word with a plural verb. However, the word government is in fact singular. While there are many people in Congress, there is only one government. The plural form of this word would be governments. See? It can be a little tricky, but you need to make sure you can spot these subtle nuances. Now, let's talk about clauses. What is a clause, you ask? Think of a clause as one single complete thought. A clause can be complex. For example, the quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog is a clause. Clauses can also be as simple as, I'm hungry. On the SAT, you'll be asked to identify errors relating to clauses. Look for run-on sentences and incomplete clauses. So, what are these? Well, if you read a sentence and it sounds like the rambling of a really talkative person, you've probably got yourself a run-on sentence. So for example, if you see, I'm really hungry, I want to go to bed, I'm tired, with no commas to combine the clauses or periods to separate the clauses, that would be a run-on sentence. The sentence should read, I'm very hungry and tired, comma, and I want to go to bed. An incomplete clause might look something like, the boy who has blue eyes. What's wrong with this sentence? It has a subject, the boy, but no verb. We have absolutely no idea what the boy who has blue eyes is doing. That's why we call this clause incomplete. The sentence should read, the boy has blue eyes. Now topic number 4, when to use I or me. You've probably heard this one used incorrectly before, but there's a very simple trick to learning this grammar rule. Let's say you have the sentence, him and me went to the store. At first glance, the sentence looks okay, but when you break the sentence apart, you realize that it's not correct. Would you ever say, him went to the store? How about, me went to the store? Probably not, right? That's how you know it's not correct. Revise the sentence to, he and I went to the store, and now it looks a lot better. Let's check the sentence using our handy dandy new trick. He went to the store. I went to the store. Both of those sentences look good to you? They sure look good to me. The next grammar topic you should be aware of is faulty comparisons. These are also a little tricky. Let's say you're given the sentence, "The people in California are better than Arizona." That sentence looks okay, right? Well, it's actually incorrect. You see, the sentence is trying to compare the people in California with the people in Arizona, not with Arizona itself. Do you see why this doesn't make sense? It's because the sentence isn't comparing two like things. It's comparing an apple and a left shoe, not two apples. The sentence should read, "The people in California are better than the people in Arizona." Doesn't that look much better? It's because the sentence is now comparing two like things. Our last topic of the day is misplaced modifiers. Sounds a little scary, doesn't it? Well, it's not so bad, I promise. Let's start off with an example. Let's say we have the sentence, "Every time he goes to the bathroom outside, Joe praises his little puppy for being good." The sentence sounds kind of okay, right? Well, it's wrong. Ask yourself, who's going to the bathroom outside? Is it Joe? His dog? Based on the sentence, we don't know, because the sentence doesn't clarify this. Anytime you see something similar to this sentence, you've got yourself a misplaced modifier. In order to correct the sentence, we must replace the word "he" with "Joe's puppy." Let's do a quick recap of everything we learned today. Today we discussed parts of speech, singular words versus plural words, clauses, when to use I or me, faulty comparisons, and misplaced modifiers. Master these grammar concepts and you'll be on your way to a stellar SAT writing score. So for all our SAT for Free students, remember that your homework is due Wednesday. For everyone else, if you'd like to get in on the action, click the link in the description and sign up for our class. It's 5 weeks long and includes 10 lessons that are absolutely free. Finally, click here if you see the importance of the SAT exam and you want more. We have customized programs, private tutoring, and a self-study course all guaranteed to increase your score. Happy learning!